Hello viewers of Biotechnica, this is Caroline Green. Today's video is going to be about PhD in Germany. We had a very specific question from an audience who was asking for, can you just make a video on PhD in Germany? Then this is specially for you and whoever is looking for a PhD opportunity in Germany, and this video is for you. We are especially going to make it for people who have asked. So I'll be talking in this video about how PhD in Germany actually work, and I'm going to talk about some of the universities and some of the scholarship and what's the grant or the general eligibility criteria if you want to apply for PhD at Germany, everything in detail. So let's talk about the first important thing is PhD at Germany, why it is really, really good enough to take PhD at Germany. Everybody knows PhD at Germany, one of the biggest advantage is free education they're going to give you. So here you're going to have for national and international students also, they are giving a free education. So that's the best thing that Germany is actually providing, and it's also believed that is the third best place ever to study in the entire world after USA and UK. And they have a very good infrastructure and very good facilities available in case of medicine as well as science and technology field. So it's always good enough that people who are trying for PhD at Germany is the best thing ever. So now let's talk about what are the ways that you can get your PhD. Very specifically, there are two important types of getting your PhD at Germany. One is going to be individual doctorate. The second one is going to be structural PhD programs. These two terminologies you have to remember, because whenever you apply, you'll be having these two options, whether you want to apply for individual doctorate or whether you want to apply for structured PhD program. So I'm going to talk about what is that individual doctorate program. Students who work on their thesis independently, which means you will be working under one PI or one principal investigator or one supervisor, and where you will be doing your own research work on your project, which means it usually majorly based on your independent work that you're going to do under the supervisor. Usually basically it does so. The second important PhD program is you're going to work in a research team under the team of supervisor. It's not going to be only one supervisor you're going to work. You're going to work under different supervisor in a team. So you're not going to work independently. You're going to work it in a team. That's going to be the structured PhD. So whoever wanted to apply for individual PhD or structured PhD program, you can definitely go in for. And if I have to talk about the duration of PhD program at Germany, usually will be 4 to 6 years, not more than that and not beneath that. Suppose most of the university you can finish off by 5 years, not more than 5 years, some university 5 to 6 years. So this is the average duration that you can do your PhD at Germany. So these two things are really, really important. Now the most important thing is what are the universities or what are the institutes that are providing PhD for life science candidates. So what you can do is, if I'm telling you this university, you can open the website and then you can check on when is the notification, when is going to be the spring, fall, they used to take it off, or summer season when they used to take off this admission protocols. You have to go and check in their website, but I'm going to give you a list of all the things. So University of Heidelberg, which is the oldest university ever, very nice university. If anybody wanted to go for University of Heidelberg, then it's a wonderful opportunity. Under University of Heidelberg, you'll be seeing a lot of research laboratories which will be coming under the university. The next one is Max Planck Society. Of course, everybody knows about Max Planck Society. In that, very specifically for biological sciences or for life sciences, you can go for International Max Planck Research School, which is IMPRS. So if you type in IMPRS, you will find all the research laboratories that comes under IMPRS. The second one is University of Tübingen. You can go for University of Tübingen also. The next one is TUM, which is Technical University of Munich. And in that, I have very specifically written Collaborative Research Center. That is Cancer Research Center. Many, many different research projects are going. And University of Leipzig and LMU University. You can also go, this is in Munich, and the next is University of Freiburg and University of Bonn, Aachen University, wonderful university, University of Göttingen and the Berlin University. So these are some of the university that I'm listing out. So very specifically, I would suggest the first, second and the fourth, and you can go for Aachen University. So these are well-known university that where you can pursue your PhD. If anybody is looking for an opportunity for PhD at Germany, then I would suggest everybody to go to the website or just type in the name of this. You will find the website. Go over there and check in for the criteria. Usually the criteria is going to be similar for all the universities. One thing you have to check is when do they ask for the PhD admissions. That only you have to check in. The next important one is I'm going to talk about the research centers which are very, very well famous in PhD. So these are some of the research center. So I'm going to list out all the research center for your convenience. This is for Center for Computational and Theoretical Biology. If anybody is interested in bioinformatics, then you can definitely go for. The next one is Experimental Molecular Medicine. This is a wonderful center. Next is Comprehensive Cancer Center, which is CCC. Next one is Comprehensive Hearing Center. And the next is Heart Failure Center. If anybody is interested in medical field, then you can take up this Hearing Center and Heart Failure Center, which are very famous over there. If anybody wanted to go in for regenerative therapies, then you can go for TLCRT. The next is German Center of Prevention Research and Mental Health. If anybody is interested in psychology, then you can go for this. The next is RNA-based infection research. So if anybody is not knowing what are the research laboratory that are well known, then I'm giving all the list. Please do take a screenshot. It will be really great help for all of you. The next one is Institute for Molecular Infection Biology. If anybody wanted to go in for infectious biology, you can go for it. Clinical research. So this is IZKF and Max Planck Research Group. Here you're going to, under Max Planck Research Society, you're going to see lot of research institute. And one of the immunology famous institute is Orberg's Institute of Systems Immunology. Wonderful area. You can go for this. The next is also in the Würzburg. So this is Early Career Center. This we don't have to prefer very specifically. Next is Research Center for Infectious Diseases. This is infectious research. This is infectious diseases. And this is for integrative and translational bioimaging. If anybody wanted to go for biophysics research, then you can definitely go for. These are some of the research institute which are very, very well known in Germany. But I'm going to talk about very specifically for oncology also in detail. Now I'm going to talk about some of the research center which have been well known. Of course, we know about the Max Planck Society and we know about the DKF, is it? I'm going to talk about DKF, is it, very specifically. So this is going to be Helmholtz Association of German Research Center. So this is an association which is the largest scientific research institute in the entire Germany. So you have to go to this Helmholtz Association of German Research Center, and if you type in over, you will find lot of research center that will be coming underneath, and they have almost 18 biological, medical and scientific technical research center. So I'm just listing some of the research center which are very popular. If anybody wanted to check very specifically of your research interest, I would suggest you to go and look in over there, because I cannot suggest what is your research interest accordingly. So you can go over there and check what is your research interest, then accordingly choose one of the things from 18. The next one is Leibniz Association. Next one is Fraunhofer's Association. Next is Max Planck Society. So under these institute, if you're going to see, you will find lot of research institute. This is all association. Under beneath this one, you will find lot of research center. So you just have to go and type in this so that you'll find all the research centers that will be coming under this one. So these are the deserving association which has all the research centers. The next important one is I'm going to talk about the general eligibility criteria if you want to go for PhD at Germany. This applies for all the universities. So there's a common protocols. So the general eligibility criteria is going to be, of course, you need to have your master's. But this master should be equal to that of a Germany eligibility criteria, which means 4 plus 2 years of experience, or 3 plus 2 years of experience, which means bachelor's and a master's degree you need to have. And they're asking a minimum GPA of 2.5 on the German grading scale. Suppose if you have 10 CGPA, if you're going to score about 9 or 8.5, then definitely you can go for this. And usually they'll ask for English proficiency requirements only. But if you're going to have a German proficiency, then it is very good enough to go in for. So if you want to have English, it's very good. So you have to write TOEFL IBT test, which you need to have a minimum of 80. So usually 120, if you're going to have it, it's very good enough to enter very easily. But if you're going to have 80, it's far enough, best enough to enter into any of the research institute. IELTS, if you're going to write, then either one of these you need to have, either a TOEFL or an IELTS. If you're going to have 6.5 to 7 bands, you can enter into most of the university. If you're going to have 7, The most important thing is if you're going to have a TOEFL score of 120 or IELTS score more than 7 band, then you can apply for a very good scholarship in the German universities. Like you can apply for DARTS fellowship. Definitely you'll get that. This matters a lot, but it's not very important that you're going to have a German language proficiency. If you're going to have a German language proficiency, then it's an added advantage for you. And of course, there will be an interview. So you can, if you're going to clear the interview, then you can definitely join the team. So if I have to talk about how the step actually works, is there are two ways of applying, as I already told you. One is going to be individually, you're going to work it separately. The second one is structured PhD program, where you're going to work under a team. So how you usually can apply is, one is approaching a PI and getting a projects under the PI, and the project will assist you in getting connected to the application process, or he'll direct you to the application process where you need to have your TOEFL or IELTS. The second method is you apply for a scholarship, and while you're applying for the scholarship, you're going to select the university. And when you get the scholarship, you can join the university of your interest. And later when you go to the university, you'll be assigned in laboratories for almost 5 to 6 months. And after that, you can choose the PI. So this is how it works in the German universities. So this is the application or the process that you can apply and you can fetch your PhD. There are some additional requirements also is asked for PhD in Germany. Some of the things is, what are the documents? So you need to have your official transcripts or your master's, your 12th or 11th or PU college, whatever you're going to have, you're going to submit it over there. Of course, your statement of purpose is really, really important. It is the one which can actually fetch you for scholarship positions also, or for your PhD positions also. Have a very good SOP. Why you are really applying for this scholarship or why you are applying for this university is a must. And a very good letter of recommendation, strong letter of recommendation. So 2 to 3. So usually when you're applying for a scholarship like DART or anything, you will be asked to submit the references over there, and they will be given a link to apply for this letter of recommendation where they'll be writing up that one. So it's not like a scan copy, you have to submit it. It doesn't work. So the next is, if you're going to have a work experience in research laboratory, you can put it over. Next is CV or your resume. And of course, any part of your research proposal. Usually research proposal, if you're going to have, it's very good enough. And I'm going to tell you another additional thing is, if you're going to have a paper publication, either it's a review article or it's going to be your work, so whatever it is, it's an other advantage for you. If you have worked as a researcher in India, then also that's an advantage for you. If you do not have a paper publication, or if you have only one review paper but with a very good index, then definitely you can apply for this one. The next important thing is finding a suitable supervisor. How you can find a suitable supervisor? As I already told you, there would be a site where you can find the PhD projects available in Germany, which is findphd.com. And you can find a project and you can mail your CV or SOP to the supervisor, or you can apply it. And he'll be calling for the interview. And after calling for the interview, if you qualify, then he'll be asking about your TOEFL or IELTS, whether you have written or not. Or he'll be giving you a time period to write TOEFL or IELTS. And after that, he will be directing you to the application portal where you'll be going and applying, so that you can enter his laboratory. And the other way it works is, you're going to apply to the scholarship portal and then you are selected. And after 6 months of training in all the laboratories, you can choose either of your PI. So this is how it works over there. So the first is going to be DART scholarship, which is German Academic Exchange Service, which is DART scholarship, wonderful scholarship. So if you're going to type DART official website, you will find lot of PhD positions available, scholarship available, everything. So DART is a must to watch out for PhD in Germany. It's a website. The next is PhD Germany. If you're going to type it, you will get everything. The next is, this is the important website, which I'm not able to pronounce it, so I'm just keeping as such. The next is going to be academics.de. The next is going to be findphd.com. So these are important websites that you can look for a specific PhD supervisor, or you can go to DKFZ, which is very specifically good for cancer research. German Research Center. If you can type in DKFZ, and if you go there, you will find lot of research supervisors and their project, and you can choose the potential supervisor of your interest. The next is going to be, what are the scholarships that are available? I'm going to list out some of the scholarships which are very, very prominent for you to apply. As I already mentioned, DART scholarship, which is German Academic Exchange Service. So here you can apply for this one. The next, as I already told you, DKFZ, which is for German research, very specifically in oncology. If anybody is interested in oncology, then you can go for DKFZ, International PhD Program in Germany. It is also a wonderful scholarship. The next is Gerda Henkel Foundation Doctoral Scholarship. The next is Max Planck Society Research Scholarship. These are most well-known scholarships. So you can also apply for this scholarship and get into the university as well. Okay, the next important one I'm going to talk about is salary prospects. So after your PhD, so usually PhD will be 5 to 6 years, and the scholarship is going to be variable according to the scholarship you're going to apply, the fundings are going to be, or according to the supervisor where you're going to work under. So I'm not doing that one, so we'll make a video on that also. The next is going to be salary prospects. If you see the average salary of people who work in LMU, TUM, and Humboldt University of Berlin, or University of Bonn, or University of Göttingen, you can literally see TUM people actually earns a bit more than anybody else, and University of Göttingen earns a lot of things. So if you're going to work in a PhD project, it's very easy for you to get into a postdoctoral positions or into a pharma company also. And people who are doing PhD in Germany, the placements are going to be like, you can enter into R&D, international research and partnership, which is you can get a postdoctoral position, or you can go and work in a pharmaceutical company. The next is permanent teaching designation. You're going to get it and then you're going to work over there. So this is all about the PhD at Germany. So I believe that this is definitely going to be a great help. And for the viewer who have asked for this question, this is exclusively for you. So if you have any questions regarding PhD at Germany, you can put it in the comment section. If you have any such kind of questions, we are ready to answer it by making a video specially for you. So I believe this video is helpful for you. If you really like this video, please like, share, and subscribe to our channel, Biotechnica. Thank you all of you for your time.